What is a Roxy girl? In my view, a Roxy girl is someone that is confident, someone adventurous, someone that knows how to enjoy life, how to respect nature and give love to the people around them and the earth that they live in. Girls that are pushing the boundaries and exploring new heights, whether it be in traveling or just the communities that they live in. People that are fun-loving and see the brighter sides of life. I first heard about the Let the Sea Set You Free contest through one of my friends. She posted a link on my Facebook, and at first I was a little bit nervous. I'm so used to creating videos for other people, and it's quite a different sensation, quite a different feeling when you have to turn the tables and focus a video on yourself. So I was nervous about it, but I was also really excited, and you know, you only live once, so I gave it my all, and here I am now, and I'm lucky to have won the Asia Pacific region of the contest. My first video touched on a little bit about me, about the things that I love, and my dreams and my aspirations, as well as the things that I do. Just a small little introduction for the voters to see if they find myself worthy of the position. In the second video, we have to explain how the sea sets us free. And actually, I would say about 4 years ago, the sea did just that. I used to work quite a full-on 9-to-5 corporate job, and had little time to myself. And although it was such a valuable experience, at the end of it I realized, you know, I have to live for the things that I love. And I quit my job, I let go of my house, my definitely, the greatest part of this experience is that Roxy has believed in us and taken our passions and, you know, put us on a platform and allowed us to, you know, creatively express the things that we love to do. And they've really been super supportive of that. And I definitely feel not so much a responsibility, but like a desire to be able to inspire other girls in, you know, chasing their dreams, and you know, also to understand how amazing this place we live in is, how truly amazing the ocean is, and how we can really benefit from it. Oh, living in Bali is amazing. Bali is I often describe it as a magnet of an island. Everyone loves to visit here, falls in love here, you know. It's a platform for our dreams to become a reality, really. As growing up in Bali, 30 years ago, we had no electricity. When I was a Grom, you know, green was the predominant color that you would see around you. And we lived such a free, you know, nature-inspired life, and that changed so quickly with how rapidly tourism exploded and how, you know, all these concrete developments. I've been lucky. When I was in high school, I started off as a photographer's assistant. I wanted to venture off into film, but as we all know, school can sometimes cost an arm and a leg. So I got this opportunity to work for an amazing clothing company here. And through that, I just got such a hunger and a taste for all the different aspects of fashion and creating and shooting and, you know, developing events. Basically, turning ideas and creating dreams and making them into reality. We all think of all the stories that we could have told. Well, having the initial dream of venturing into film, this experience with Let the Sea Set You Free really opened that door and really exhibited to me even more that that's the direction I would love to go in. I would love to create films. I would love to travel the world. I would love to, you know, be influenced and be able to document not only the beautiful parts of the world, but also the beautiful people that are in it. Our first trip to Biarritz, France for the Roxy Pro was mind-blowing. I mean, from the minute that we arrived, the team itself are such a kind, talented group of people, and they brought us to the most stunning house, you know, and meeting the two other girls, you know, they're such blossoming, talented women. It was an honor to be a part of that group. Biarritz is such a stunning place. It's hard to describe. I would say it's a cross between France and Spain, and there's so much culture, and the people are so vibrant, and the energy is so alive. And the Roxy Pro itself is such an impressive operation. I mean, bringing together the best women surfers in the world, and being able to watch them do their thing is truly inspirational. I mean, these girls are not only do they rip, but they're all, you know, they all have other passions on the sides. They're into fashion, they're into the arts, and also giving back to the community. One day, baby, we'll be old. Well, baby, we'll be old. Think of all the stories that we could have told. People would have to be my number one. My family. We've gone through a lot, and we continue to go through a lot. So at the moment, family is a big focus in trying to keep us together and keep things harmonious and to move forward with that. So supporting each and every one of my family members to be all that they can be and happy. My friends and the environment. I think that's on the top of the list at the moment, in trying to find a positive way in how we can give back to Mother Earth. And when I feel wonder why, baby, we'll be old. Oh, baby, we'll be old. Think of all the stories that we could. There's so many things I want to do. There's so many dreams that I'm envisioning in my head right now. But venturing into the film line of work, of passion, of creativity, is definitely something that I really want to explore right now, and just improve my photography skills and my understanding of that field. So you can follow me via Instagram. At the moment, I'm developing a website which will feature all the projects that I've been a part of, the places that I've visited, the amazing people that I've met. The name and the platform is still in the works, but let's say look out for the word madness. It will involve some form of madness. And yeah, when it's up and running, I'll definitely find a way to spread the word. Top three songs on my iPod at the moment would have to be number one on repeat, rewind, replay, can't get enough, I'm gonna get sick of it in about 3 weeks song would be One Day, or otherwise known as The Reckoning Song by Asaf Avidan. The Seed by The Roots, can never get enough of that song. And when I'm feeling a little bit melancholy, I like to switch on some Ben Howard or some Ben Harper. Forever is probably one of my all-time favorite songs.
Baby, we'll be old. Oh, baby, we'll be old and think of all the stories.
Last words, live the life you love. Never stop believing. Never stop being hungry for exploring the world and giving love to the people around you. A big thank you to everyone, to all my friends, my family, this killer community that have supported me. Not only through the Let the Sea Set You Free, but since I was a bubba till now, you know, everyone has always believed in me, and I really appreciate that from the bottom of my heart. And thank you to Baliradio.net for having me on board.
Woo! Yoo-hoo!